finally back in the green hill. We drove the 100 kilometers from Spa-Francorchamps and arrived in the Barweiler of the Nürburgring and prepared to spend Saturday and Sunday driving Touristenfahrt. It was 1 week after the famous 24-hour race where the whole track had been drowned in heavy rain. So, what am I doing here? Wandering along the fences of the Nürburgring. Shouldn't I be driving my Giulietta? Well, the truth is, my generator finally packed up. The charging light had been showing at Spa-Francorchamps, and Saturday morning here at the Nürburgring, it finally gave in. So, I was stranded more or less. But it gave me the opportunity to get some impressions for this video. Impressions from the track side of the Nürburgring. I had brought with me from back home the stick. My colleague from work, he drives a BMW M Roadster and rides a Yamaha R1 motorcycle on track days. He was a bit anxious to go out on the Nürburgring after having driven with everybody else at the Spa-Francorchamps the day before. I could show him in my Giulietta, but he actually leapt at the chance and bought a ticket with the Ring Taxi. So we joined him. And we were lucky enough to get a lap with Dale Lomas, whom we know from years back when he was at Renfrew Ring.
You haven't tried it yet?
Not tried it yet, but my friend is bringing this new one. Oh.
This time, I didn't know that my generator would eventually fail.
First lap. Let's see.
So I did what I always do. I went out on a reconnaissance lap. I brought Michael with me in the passenger seat for an easy peasy lap.
Er du frisk?
Yes.
Skal du være der med benene og det?
Ja,
ja.
way down from Kallenhardt to Breitscheid, my charging light lit up, just like it had done for 2 minutes maybe on Spa the previous day. I thought that maybe if I took it a little easy up Kesselchen, it would turn off again. So I drove on a little anxious. I had prepared this weekend at the Nürburgring to be a multi-lap, many laps outing, where I would get a lot of good photos and maybe some video from the track side. But I was beginning to feel that maybe this would not happen.
Min ladelampe lyser.
Ja.
Jeg ved ikke, om min generator vil gå i stykker. Det er lidt irriterende.
Jeg så, det er bare en kæft.
Ja. Det kommer, det er skidt ned på spag også. Så kører det lidt videre, den bliver kold igen, så venter den at lade igen. Det er ikke sikkert, at den kan blive ved med at holde til det jo.
Ja, det er ikke en ny bil.
Nej, det er en ny generator. Men det er fra en MG.
Okay. Det er jo det mest driftsbil, du kan vælge.
Ja, det er sindssygt.
Det kan være, at Magic Smoke kan komme ud af den.
Jeg kører ikke gang mere. Jeg er nødt til lige at lige, se, om jeg kan få den til at slukke der. Men ellers så bruger jeg bare alt batteriet, og så kan den ikke køre mere.
Ja. Fuck en oplevelse. Hold da kæft.
Det er en anden oplevelse, ikke?
Ja, det er meget en oplevelse. Meget mere autentisk.
Ja.
Men jeg er imponeret over, hvor godt den egentlig bider.
Ja. Altså, ja, den har, man skal bare sørge for at holde den til ilden, så kan man godt få den rundt, ellers kan den altså godt begynde at understyre lidt.
Ja, når den kommer over de der 5,5, så lyder den fandme også godt.
Eller jeg skal lige tjekke her.
Det er jo det. Jeg så det. Det er det billigste.
Ja. Ja. Så er jeg i gang.
Ja, det skal jeg love for. Tag lige stille og roligt første runde.
Ja, men altså så stille og roligt, som det nu er nødvendigt, og så kan man sige så. Bare det er også farligt at køre langsomt.
Med hjulspind
og
skridende dæk, igen, det er rigtigt. Mm. Og det er det, der er nakkest.
Åh, oh, pis, du kan ikke starte.
Skal jeg skubbe? Nu skal jeg gøre det.
Ja, så må de køre rundt om. Jeg kan simpelthen ikke komme til. Ah! Så vi kan stoppe den. Pis. Jeg må huske starte den i bakgear, tror jeg.
Vent lidt. Kan du skubbe starte den?
Ja, i bakgear.
Hvad?
I bakgear.
Kun i bakgear?
Ja, vi venter lidt. Vi venter lidt. Jamen, fordi så er den der nede af bakgear.
So I spent the next couple of hours lying on my backside on my nice green carpets looking for the fault. It was very important for me to make sure that it was an electrical fault. I didn't bring many tools, but I had enough with me to establish that the generator could not make its own magnetic field. This is a generator in a dynamo housing. It's a Lucas lookalike. And the next time I'll try and get the Bosch part. I went to Ron Simmons Racing and they were kind enough to lend me some measuring tools, and eventually I ended up with a very nice race workshop across the Dötzinger Höhe Street, where they had some exciting cars in the garage as well. I called my insurance back in Denmark, and I was able to convince them that I was unable to fix the car in Germany. There's a very nice amendment to my insurance that under such circumstances, they will tow my car back to Denmark free of charge. The car was collected by the famous Bundgaards towing company from Adenau. They have the very famous yellow trucks that tows the cars away from the Nürburgring. They would collect the car, and the next day another company would come and get it, drive it to the Danish border, and eventually it should arrive back home with Steffen in his garage. So I decided just to make the best out of the situation. I had 8 laps left on my ring card, and the least I could do was to drive with the other guys in their cars. Monday morning, we prepared for the return trip, and I hitched a ride with Gerd Sterner. We stayed with the Puderbach family in Barweiler, and Mr. Puderbach had actually worked 34 years at the Nürburgring, and he showed me his very exciting memorabilia collection. Meanwhile outside, Gerd and Michael, they changed the brake pads on Gerd's Thunderbolt. I think it was about time.